the recognized worldwide leader in sports.
Green Bay is home to both the National Museum of Nature and Wildlife, as well as Rail America, the National Railroad Museum. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Wrestling Challenge. I'm Gorilla Monsoon, and joining me here with his bevy of beauties, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Are you ready for the action?
Yes, I'm always ready, and we've got excitement and action coming at you right here.
I guess you shut these people up.
It's coming right now.
Challenge. 2 true tragedy begin innocently enough, late on a snowy night in Waukesha, Wisconsin, when a hungry Ken Patera went to a fast food restaurant after a grueling match. According to newspaper reports, Ken Patera was denied service, told that the restaurant was closed for the night. It is alleged that Ken Patera and a co-defendant threw a rock through the restaurant window, resulting in a call to the police. The police arrived at Ken Patera's motel, and a melee ensued between a number of local police, Ken Patera, and a co-defendant. Patera was arrested and charged with a felony. He went to trial and was found guilty. In these days of rapists, kidnappers, and murderers, plea bargaining for a fraction of their sentences, or even getting off scot-free, Patera was sentenced to 2 years in prison. There were many who felt that a first-time offender, a man who represented his country in international competition, should not have received such a harsh sentence. Who's to blame? The judicial system? Society? Or does Ken Patera bear the full brunt on his own wide shoulders? And what was it like for a man in the prime of his career to spend two long, hard years in prison? Let Ken Patera tell you.
I accept full responsibility for my actions. Nobody's above the law. Nobody knows that better than Ken Patera. I accept full blame for it. I should have never listened to people like Bobby Heenan, somebody that creates a problem and just walks away. When I was down, I need moral support. There was no phone calls, no letters, no visits. You completely abandoned me, Bobby. What was it like sitting in jail, being in prison? The disgrace I brought upon my loved ones, my family, my friends, the disgrace I brought up myself. I hope to make it right by ridding the world of people like you, Bobby Heenan. I paid for my mistakes.
About you, I haven't had that much of an interest, but you're from where?
Fiji Islands.
From the Fiji Islands. From the Fiji Islands. That's where they have Fiji Islands. That's where they have those big trees with coconut stuff, right? And your folks run up and down for coconuts like monkeys and stuff like that. Is that the place I'm talking about? No, what I'm trying to say to you, I don't know anything about. Hey, don't get me wrong. Now, I don't know anything about the Fiji Islands. They must have lots of nice. They got big women. I know they got big women there in the Fiji Islands.
They got nice women.
Oh, I'm sure they got nice women. Nothing nice long hair under their armpits. Just a little joke there. Just a little joke, fella. Fiji Islands, huh? Fiji Islands. You were born in the Fiji Islands?
Born and raised.
What do you eat in the Fiji Islands? What would you do in the Fiji Islands for fun?
Eating fish.
For fun, you eat fish. That's great. You eat fish for fun. I understand in the Fiji Islands, one of the things you do in the Fiji Islands, what they do is they have the coconuts at the top of the tree, and what you do is you climb up the tree with the coconuts, and you shake the tree. You shake the tree, and the coconuts fall down right on the women's head. Boom, it's kind of handy, though. Splits the coconuts open, kind of makes them with the women a little backwards, makes the kid a little backwards, but nevertheless, it's really handy for the coconuts. What I'm trying to say to you is because you come from the Fiji Islands, and you're telling me how nice the Fiji Islands are, what are you doing here?
Can I just tell you something? Are you trying to put my race and my...
No. By no means, I'm not trying to put your race out. I'm just asking you, what are you doing here?
Excuse me.
No, wait. You're taking this all wrong. I don't know nothing about the Fiji Islands, and you obviously know nothing about Piper's Pit. So that kind of makes me a little superior to you. What I'm trying to say to you is, you're here, you have a whole bunch of people. What does this mean? Let me ask you something. Am I going over your head? What does this mean?
This means I... love you. That's what it means.